Get ready to match the stars. Jim Backus. Brett Summers. Nipsey Russell. Patty Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson.
Everybody okay?
Everything is.
We're all
you look splendid.
Darling.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
I think I'll kiss you as a symbolic kiss for
as
the whole.
To him.
Well,
as opposed
don't kiss
to him.
Me. There's a lot of talk going around about
you and your
that's the show for today, folks. Now, what do you say we greet our two players here, Josephine Williams and Emmy Rick? Hello there, ladies. Emmy is our current champion. She's won one game, and she went for the whole ball of wax and got it, as $5,600 to her credit. We've started her second game here. She's being challenged by Josephine Williams. We finished round one. It's 3-2 in favor of Josephine, and we're going to go to round two right after we go to this. So don't go away. Okay, ready, ladies? Let us go to round two. 3-2 in favor of Josephine, our challenger. And would you make the selection, please?
B.
She wants B. Last time out, you matched three celebrities, Jim, Brett, and Patty. So now you'll be trying to match Nipsey, Richard, and Betty. Here we go. Alex and Shirley got drunk at the party and tried to do the tango in the blank. You're sorry you're not playing, huh?
Yeah.
I'm not.
That's just right.
You're not playing. Yeah. No. You're not playing.
No. You're not playing.
No. I'm such a beautiful.
Would you like to whisper it to
me? No. I don't know you that well.
Alex and Shirley got drunk at the party, tried to do the tango in the blank. Nipsey, you're drawing a picture up there.
No.
Oh.
What happened?
Okay, here we go.
I made my teeth go funny because it.
All right, Josephine, we'll call on you for your response to this. Alex and Shirley got drunk at the party, tried to do the tango in the.
Nude.
In the nude. That's her answer. Nude is her answer, Nipsey. What is your answer?
Well, I never would believe a nice lady like that would have said a thing, but I thought I would.
Nude. So you're up to four, Josephine. And here's a man I would expect to say nude.
Well, I'm just in shock. A lovely school teacher yesterday, she said the bird got shot.
Yes.
The day the couple were in the... They tried to do the tango in the pool.
In the pool.
With Lloyd Bridges on harp.
However, you must admit,
yes.
Her music classes must be interesting.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Not
oh, yeah.
They do their tangos
in the nude.
Imagine Betsy Ross saying in the nude.
All right, so you're up to five. And now, Emmy, your half of this round, you must score three to maintain a tie. Four, however, will win the game for you. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Last time out, you matched two celebrities, Nipsey and Betty, so the two of you will lay out and the rest of you will participate. Kathy said...
We've told you not to say layout, James.
Oh, I'm sorry. You will not participate, Nipsey and Betty. Kathy said... Marvin's no fun at all. We went to a drive-in movie last night, and all he wanted to do was blank. You've been out with Marvin, lady? Is that why you... Kathy said, Marvin's no fun. We went to a drive-in movie last night, and all he wanted to do was blank. All right. Here we go. Emmy, we call for your response. We went to a drive-in movie last night, and all he wanted to do was...
Eat popcorn.
Eat popcorn. Well, I... All right, well, we'll find
Come
out.
On.
Come on now. Eat popcorn is her answer. Jim, what did you say?
My answer kind of reveals my age, just as the phraseology when I was young. Neck.
Neck. All right. Now, you must match the remaining ones. Brett, eat popcorn is her answer.
Well, Marvin's real name was Jack Klugman. And all he wanted to do was watch the film.
All he wanted to do was watch the film. That does not match. So Josephine is our winner. Congratulations. Would you come around, Josephine? Okay. Stand by here for a moment. We congratulate you. And, Emmy, what's wrong there? The microphone? Oh, well, all right, I'll get the mic. Don't worry about it. They forgot to hang it. Don't make a big deal out of it. I just walk over here like this. The camera follows me, and I pick up the microphone, which should have been on this hook all along, and I leave it there. That's how it's too bad. See? Okay. Now, Emmy, you're going to leave here with $5,600. I know that makes you happy. Many thanks for being with us on Match Game 73. Emmy Rick. Oh, there's the microphone. You know what this means?
Yes.
What's it mean?
That I'm going to get a chance at $500 or $250 or $100.
Well, the total could be over $5,000. Uh-huh. We polled a recent studio audience, Josephine, and we got their best response to this. Under blank, or under blank, whatever accent you want to put on it is okay with us. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. Third, $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Nipsey?
Yeah.
Nipsey?
Yes.
What?
Understanding.
Understanding. That's his answer. Okay.
Getting restless.
Another celebrity?
Betty.
Underwear.
Underwear.
Yeah, yeah. If you people
I don't know what this audience is cheering about. They look like a bunch that's not even wearing any. Okay. One more celebrity.
Jim.
Where?
What's that?
Where?
No, no, well, that's
underwear
done.
Has already been. We've got understanding and underwear.
Ground.
Underground.
Ground.
Okay.
That's a good one.
So there are the three, Josephine: underwear, understanding, and underground. Now you may choose one of those, or think up one of your own and give it to us. But we need an answer now.
Underwear.
Underwear is what she said. That's Betty White's answer. Okay, that's
Make
the one
break,
we were looking
Jane.
For. That's the one we are looking for. May we see the $100 response? Undercover. Still no underwear. But it may be right here coming up. Let's find out together. Here's the $250 response. Underwear it is. Very well done, Betty White. Josephine. All right, Josephine, you've got the $250. You now play for 10 times that amount, or
$2,500.
Oh, you want to see what the $500
is? Yes, you must.
You are
yes, I do.
Curious
yeah.
bunch,
and Jim would,
you?
Too.
I would,
right.
too.
We will show you the $500 response. Underdog.
Underdog.
I was sure it was going to be growl.
Yes.
Underground seemed like a pretty logical one. Underdog it was. All right, to collect the $2,500, Josephine, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match, and it's time to choose that celebrity now.
Betty.
Betty, it's you. You get ready to write. Josephine, you face me if you would, please. And I'll get the $2,500 question. Please write your answer to this, Betty. Half blank. H-A-L-F blank. All right. Betty is finished.
I'll say in the business.
And Josephine, it's time to get an answer from you. H-A-L-F, half blank.
Gallon.
Half gallon. Is that what you say? Okay, Betty. For $2,500, may we see your answer, please?
Josephine, half-baked.
Half-baked. All right.
Let's
hear a big
underwear.
Offer, Josephine, here. Okay. While you're owing, I'll remind Josephine that she's up to $350. She's going to play another game, meet another challenger, right after we meet these messages. All right, let's welcome a new player. Here is Mr. Myron Nisley. Hi, Myron. Can I tell you your name? Okay. You want to tell us where you're from, a little bit about the story of your life?
In 10 seconds. I'm a native native Californian, wife, two kids, daughter 14 going on 25.
Yep.
And a son 12 just going on.
I guess we all understand that, don't we? All right, good luck to you here, Myron. You know that you and Josephine will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and we'll have a chance at the super match where you can win over $5,000. Here we go. Challenger, would you please make a selection?
I'll try A.
He wants A. Everybody will play. This is it.
Seems to be your problem.
What is it, sweetheart?
I'll tell you, darling.
Why can't
I think it would be very appropriate if you read this, because I see it begins, when nearsighted Mr. Magoo walked past the gorilla cage at the zoo, he said...
Why, young lady, they shouldn't have put you in jail just because you need a...
More time for Myron. When nearsighted Mr. Magoo walked past the gorilla cage at the zoo, Myron, he said, why, young lady, they shouldn't have put you in jail just because you need a blank.
Great, you do it better than me.
All right, everybody ready? Brett and Nipsey, are you ready?
Right.
No.
You haven't even started.
Well, I'm starting.
I don't understand the question yet.
No, those quick nip. You're a little less.
Got the idea? Okay.
Well, sort of, but not really.
All right, now they're all set, so Myron will call on you. Mr. Magoo said, why, young, when he walked past the gorilla cage at the zoo, he said, why, young lady, they shouldn't have put you in jail just because you need a...
haircut.
Haircut. That's his answer. Haircut is what he said. What did Mr. Magoo say?
Mr. Magoo said, my George, and I've got the money to buy George. Shave.
Shave. That match a haircut? No, not match. Sorry, Ken. Shave and a haircut are two different things that cannot match. Brett.
Have you noticed that I've gotten better this week?
No.
Yes.
No.
I have.
Miss Betsy Ross speaks up.
Yes.
Go home and fix your flag. I said haircut.
Haircut. There's one match. What do you say, Nipsey?
Well, if it had been long hair, you would have never said young lady, but it would have been a boy. I said, just because you need a bath.
Need a bath. All right. What do you say, young lady?
Whatever young lady says, you need a shave.
A shave. Yes. A shave. All right.
That's cutting it rather
close. He's looking for a haircut. What are you offering, Richard?
Shave and a haircut.
Well, I can let him have a shave.
Shave. Okay. What do you say, lady?
That's a sharp answer. Shave.
Shave. Yeah. Okay. So you scored once with that. Let's see how Josephine does with this. Everybody plays. Kermit always has to hold on to his toupee while he and Hortense are blanking.
Kermit.
Always has to hold on to his toupee while he and Hortense are blanking. Now, you've got to write an answer.
I'm never coming to your dressing room again.
And I read well and all that, but do something with
that. Oh,
okay. Yeah. All right. Lower tier is ready, upper tier. Now the upper tier is ready, so we'll call on Josephine Williams. Kermit always has to hold on to his toupee while he and Hortense are...
making love.
Making love. What a cackler we've got over there. Would you do that once more, madam?
I think she's just been fired.
Yes.
The song she teaches in that music class.
Josephine's answer is making love. Jim, what did you think of?
Boy, I wish I had a teacher like that when I was...
I did, that's why I turned out the way I did.
Yeah. He says. All right.
What did you say, Dave?
Dancing.
That's an interesting picture.
Yeah. I said...
Would you stand up? Hold on, would you just stand up for a second here?
What?
Let's see now. He said dancing.
Yes.
And when they're dancing, he would hold on to his toupee.
Yes.
And they'd... Oh, I see. I got the idea. Very well done, Jim.
Yeah, sit down.
Yes, you
anything.
May sit down now.
I think you owe Patty an apology.
No.
Go.
You've got to get your glasses tuned up.
Make
I said love. Bowling. You see when a man goes, I had to do it.
Oh, I see.
He thought I said
bowling. I see. Okay.
Can you imagine?
Making love is her answer. Nipsey,
well, people don't dance cheek to cheek anymore. You
oh, they
know,
don't.
They dance all
oh,
night.
Yeah, right.
So I
far
said,
apart. Dancing.
It.
All right.
The floor is crowded.
No match yet, Josephine. Let's see what you've got, Patty.
How close to making love is kissing?
I don't know. How close to making love is kissing? Is that a match, yes or no? No, I say no.
You make love after you kiss.
I see.
Or before.
We didn't ask for it in chronological order, Nipsey.
Richard Dawson, what do you say?
Well, you see, I was smart. I stayed in after school with Josephine. I'm now getting to know how she thinks.
So, loving.
Loving.
Maybe love. Very nice, Josephine. Score at this moment is tied. Let's see if Pretty Betty White unties it.
Kiss me, Gene.
Kiss you. All right. Okay, so there's a tie here, 1-1, and we've got another round to go to, and we'll go to that round right after we go to this, and I'll kiss Betty White while you're away. All right, here we go with round two. Score tied here, 1-1. Myron, if you're ready, would you make a selection?
I'll try B this time.
He wants B. Last time out, you matched Brett, so Brett, you will not participate. The others will. The Sultan's 50 wives went on strike, saying, "We really need more than one blank." Does everyone understand the question? The Sultan's 50 wives went on strike, saying, "We really need more than one blank." Okay? Myron's thinking very deeply about that.
I'm thinking very deeply about it, but I'm not allowed to say.
No,
you get
that's
a stunt
right.
check if you are.
Now, Nipsey's ready, so we'll get an answer from Myron. What do you say, Myron? Sultan's 50 wives went on strike saying, "We really need more than one blank."
Husband.
More than one husband. Okay. Sounds like a reasonable request to me.
Certainly.
What do you say, Jim?
What?
I said, eunuch.
We need more than one eunuch.
Yeah.
I see.
Take you back to the home.
All right, Brett, show. Oh, no, you're not participating. Nipsey, what did you say?
I'd like to disassociate myself with this panel and say,
kitchen. Yes. So far, we got two rotten answers, and now let's see what we get from Patty. Husband is Myron's answer.
Does a sultan count as a husband?
Oh, no, yeah, that's a match, indeed. We need more than one sultan. Yeah, okay, very good. Richard?
We need more than one man.
Got another match? Yes, it is. Okay.
What's
so
Betty White
you're getting
none.
Rolling here. All right, Miss White.
We need more than one John. John Sultan, will you find out?
Okay. So, Myron, you got two matches and a lot of laughs. So, what more can you ask for? Let's see what we do here with Josephine's end of the round. You've got to match two celebrities to achieve a tie. Three will win the game, Josephine. This is it. Last time out, you matched Richard. So, Richard, you will not play. Cynthia said, "I don't care what you say. I think King Kong is much blanker than the Jolly Green Giant." Cynthia said that. "I don't care what you say, I think King Kong is much blanker than the Jolly Green Giant."
I'm ready.
All right. Oh, this is moving along very rapidly here, folks. Josephine. Cynthia said, "I don't care what you say, I think King Kong is much whatter than the Jolly Green Giant."
Taller.
Taller, she says. Okay, Jim, that's her answer. You need two to tie, three to win. Go.
I think I said bigger, which is...
I don't know about that. Bigger and taller. That is a match. Okay, you got one there. Now, Brett.
Well, I know both of them, and I said sexier.
Sexier. Okay. And Nipsey.
Yeah, the Sultan's wife said, "We really need more than one turn."
The no, Sultan, I'm sorry. Oh, that's the last question.
Sexier
is his answer. All right, Josephine, you need one more to tie. Two will win. Patty.
Sexier.
See, now,
go.
You've got to match Betty White, or it's all over.
You let us down. We'll never come to class again. Sexier.
Sexier. So our new champion is Myron Sisley. Come on down, Myron. Is congratulations to you. Stand by for a moment. We'll say goodbye to Josephine Williams. It's been grand meeting you and having you here on Match Game 73. You've won a total of $350, and we thank you. Josephine Williams. We'll come back to Myron right after these messages. Myron Sisley will be back whenever we get together next time. And he's going to have a go at over $5,000 here in the Supermatch. And I hope you'll be watching. And yeah, I hope you'll be watching, too, and paying attention. Yes. Because you're going to be
involved in that. We'll be listening anyhow.
Very deeply. Listen, Brett, how are things going on your TV show, the new Perry Mason?
I love it. I'm doing the fifth one next week, and I love it.
Is it fun to do, really?
Yes. Well, as I said before, it's easy. And easy is sometimes better than fun. This is fun to do.
Good. All right. We'll look forward to seeing all of you next time. Is there some wise word of wisdom that you'd like to leave us with, sir, before we go?
Yes, if at first you don't succeed, give up. There's no need being silly.
Good. All right. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Big Fall Catalog. His or her straddle light luggage for those advanced style, plus lightweight packability from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And Legs, super stretching, super fitting pantyhose made to fit your legs. No bags, no sags. Legs hug you, hold you, never let you go. And Tootsie Roll Flavor Rolls. Good old chewy Tootsie Rolls. Now in a rainbow of five flavors you can eat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.